The history of women in the workforce has always been a struggle for equal rights, representation, and pay equality. The very first women's labor union, the Daughters of St. Crispin, was founded in 1869. However, mirroring their male counterparts throughout history, many women's unions were focused on specific occupations and discrimination based on race, religion, or origin.
In the 1970s, women represented 43% of the labor force. The popular progressive protests of the era, cultural forces, and feminist movements were coalescing into an impetus for the National Organization for Women under the wing of the AFL-CIO. One of the forces behind this movement was Olga Madar, a leader in the United Auto Workers Union and soon to be the first president of the Coalition of Labor Union Women. Madar was a trailblazer in the struggle for equal rights, fighting to end racial discrimination and a champion of women's rights since the 1940s. Following months of discussion and planning, on March 24, 1974, over 3,000 determined labor union women and supportive feminists from across the United States convened in Chicago to create the Coalition of Labor Union Women, the CLUW, an organization to address the critical needs of millions of unorganized working women and to make unions more responsive to the needs of all working women. The CLUW even included men in its ranks to show its inclusiveness and highlight its egalitarian message.
Since its formation, the CLUW has been at the forefront of women's and labor movements, leading on issues such as childcare, sexual harassment, and pay equality, and taking its message worldwide, empowering women's workers globally.